I decided to disassemble Sony Model 1 3D glasses to remove the sprocket that links left and right eye adjustment together. Since the device doesn't have any warranty labels covering any bolts, I guess it's safe to assume disassembling it won't void the warranty. Thanks for that. Before you start, make sure you have all necessary tools. Don't fool yourself that having 100 different screwdrivers makes it obvious you have the one for Sony. I didn't, and even tried to reshape a couple of cheap ones to fit the 8 tiny screws on the side of the device. It didn't work, and I had to borrow 2 sets of better quality precision screwdrivers. The one that fits is 0.50 Phillips screwdriver. Another match is one marked PH000. So, let's start. First, unscrew 4 screws holding the upper plate near the forward pad. Now unscrew the spring and the pad holders. Now remove the screws holding the white plastic part. For the side screws, use the screwdriver I mentioned before. Remove the white plastic. There is a funny thing about it though. Do you see a blue marker dot? They marked this at the factory since it has one of the screw posts damaged. So they knew the part was defective but still decided to install it. It's a Sony. I guess I'll have to glue it. Yet another interesting point. Some complain about audible buzz in the left headphone. Well, after opening the unit, the reason for the noise is obvious. The left headphone wire is tied around the main signal cable, which carries DC current as well. So to reduce the noise, you have to at least move the speaker cable away from the signal one, wiring it through already existing holders. Now, unscrew the side panels of the headphones. To remove one, gently pluck it with your fingernails. There are four more screws hidden under the panels, holding the headphones, two for each. Disconnect the headphones, unscrew and remove them. Remove the screws on the upper panel. Remove the screws on the lower panel, two on each side. Remove the screws near the lenses. Now release the lower panel and unscrew the button assembly. Be careful with the wiring. Our gear wheel is that way. You may disconnect the signal cable so it won't get in the way. Gently pull the OLED wiring from under the hooks. Unscrew the circuit board. Peel one side of the tape holding the wire. There is a screw under it, remove it. Now gently pull one part against the other. Here's our sprocket. Two metal tongues provide steps in the eye length adjustment. Removing them will eliminate steps, making it fluid, but I don't recommend that since the lenses won't hold in place, ruining your adjustment with each turn of the head. Gently press the anchors of the gear wheel and remove it. It feels like this is meant to be removed. Just why did they put it here in the first place, forcing the end user to unscrew over 9,000 screws to get down to it? Now the lenses could be adjusted independently, increasing the number of possible eye lens positions from 5 to 25. And while we are on improvement spree, let's deal with the left headphone wiring. At the very least, move it away from the power line. You can also shield it using a piece of insulation from an old computer mouse cable, shielded UTP, or any other shielded cable. I decided to use a filter cut from a USB cable. Just push the wire through the filter and hide it inside the body. There's plenty of space there. Reassemble everything, so now you can adjust each eye separately, and the only remaining audio noises are from the scan, but that's electronics related.